Hello everyone and welcome back to Assassin's Creed Syndicate, where we had last left off. We had played as Jack the Ripper and killed some people. And broke up people inside the asylum. We now need to break our way in. I don't know why she didn't find it properly.
Try to calm down.
Oh boy, there's a bunch of stuff here. Yo. This is the same way Jacob got in. At least when I played it.
Jack's trail of death continues.
How is that Jack the Ripper? He doesn't look anything like the guy I was chasing or playing as. Indian Emerald!
You make a mockery of what I had to endure in that office by dismissing it and...
He's not going to be dead, he's going to be knocked out. What the hell is that big blue thing?
I'll put an end to that noise.
See, I have to actually force her to do it.
Jack's games. There must be other messages for me.
You will like your prize, but you must descend into the abyss to retrieve it.
So I need to go down below.
In the basement. That is where Jack will spring his final trap.
That kind of rhymes. Thank you.
What's going on?
I don't trust you, lady!
Damn it, I thought I saw a chest up here. Oh, it's going around.
Quiet life.
Oh no! Oh no! No!
I don't like this!
You're gonna go to sleep. Don't worry. Everything's fine. Out and round, which I cannot do on this side. No, no, go, go. Come on, what are you doing? How far down do I need to go?
Jacob?
Welcome to the reunion, Miss Braun.
Okay, you got cut off at the end, mate. I mean, Jacob's right here. You're not going to try and break him free? He probably would help. Whoa, what was that?
There is a sickness.
Pathetic. Don't make me laugh.
That's useless.
Oh, I think I may faint.
I'm getting nowhere. I should flee and try sneaking up on him.
Oh, really?
There is a sickness in this world, Miss Fry. It made our... There is a sickness in this world, Miss Fry. It made our crew.
Bye-bye.
But I am here now. I will tear into all sickness, all the rot and shit of this city, and rip it out.
What are you doing? God!
Shall be pure again. The assassin shall rise, and we shall rule.
Shall we?
Are you cat or mouse, Miss Fry?
Neither. I'm an assassin. Yes, eat it.
cowardly and inept as your twin. Still think you can hide from me?
I mean, I just did, so...
Jacob thought he could hide from me, too. Cowering in the shadows, Miss Fry.
Gotcha! Eat it! And of course you dropped a fear bomb.
What?
Jack the Ripper cannot die! That woman thinks you're mad! Free yourselves! Kill that mad woman!
I know you blame Jacob for your mother's death, but nothing can excuse the horrors you've committed. Jacob was like a father to you, Jack. You have betrayed his trust and sullied the creed!
How do you know that? You only met him when he came to the village to get trained.
Show me your monster assassin!
Oh, hi again.
You are weak, assassin!
A relic just like your precious creed.
Gotcha!
You will not make a monster of me!
Seeing as we're doing a brutal kill on him, I doubt that.
You will not make a monster of me!
Is he dead?
We're the same, you and I.
Oh, Jack. You were an assassin, yes, but we are not the same. And that is why your memory must be erased for all time.
Well, he's not.
Rest in peace now, Jack. You and your twisted acolytes.
So much for not making a monster out of you, seeing as you're being all smiley and happy at his death.
Jacob.
Miss Fry, what the hell happened here?
Nothing, Inspector. Nothing happened here. Trust me. Jack the Ripper's dead.
Inspector!
Now help me, Frederick. No one must ever know that Jack the Ripper was an assassin.
I want those vultures gone this instant, is that clear?
It's over, Jacob. I'm here.
Well then. That's it? It's just gonna end like that? Wow. I mean, it's a nice sort of ending with Jacob and Evie, where Evie's like actually caring about her brother. X. Faster! Faster! Skip. Avoid detection, nuclearize Jack 3 criminals. Assassin Gauntlets, the Ripper's Terror. Okay, I'll give it a 2. Are we going to be teleported somewhere else? DLC Family Reunion plus 15. I'm invisible! And I'm back in. Oh! We're just here now. This is Jacob's room, isn't it? So I guess that's it. That's the DLC. I actually thought it'd be a bit longer than that. So, final thoughts on Jack the Ripper DLC. Much shorter than I anticipated. It felt like it was being put forward as like this big, expansive, like, new content that you could play. And don't get me wrong, there are quite a few side missions, but that's pretty much what this DLC is. It's more side missions than actual content. If I'm being honest, the final fight with Jack the Ripper was actually really disappointing. Like, all we get from this DLC about Jack in this world, not the real world, is that he was an assassin, he was saved from the asylum by Jacob, and then turned bad for some reason, even though Jacob freed the guy from the asylum. Was he a Templar? We don't know, because I don't think he was, because he had Templars inside the prison yard place. And then all of a sudden, for some reason, Evie just knows everything about Jack. It's like, oh, I know he raised you like a father. And it's like, how? How do you know that? Just because he was a kid and was being trained by him doesn't mean that he's being treated like a son. How does that make any sense? And then it's like, oh, yeah, try to help you, and it's like, you won't make me into a monster. And yet it seems like he did, seeing as you were smiling and like gleeful that he died. And like I said, when that last murder took place, she was very angry about it, as though she had a personal stake in it, but she didn't know the person that died. She was not a part of that at all, and she only appeared there just to nerd about it. And then she's like, oh my god, oh, I'm gonna beat up police officer now. And it's like, what? Why? The DLC is too short to properly give Jack the Ripper a sense of self. Like, too little is done to make him a character. It was cool, like, I like the whole fear effect things. But I don't like the fact that for some reason Evie has been made to not be able to kill someone without outright getting them to do it. Like, every single assassination you do, you're not killing them, you're knocking them out. Unless you press X on them again when they're on the floor, then you stab them. Which just makes an extra step that's not needed. And the only reason why I think they would do that is to show a polar opposite to Jack. Whereas Jack would just kill someone outright, Evie would first knock them out and then decide if she wants to kill them or not. Whereas in... that does not work in the context of the series, seeing as every other game before that, you've killed your targets. Evie has killed her targets. And yet for some reason, all of a sudden, she doesn't want to. It doesn't give in-game reasons. You just have to, you kind of have to make up why or try and figure out why, because it doesn't outright state it, which it technically should. Otherwise, it just makes it a game mechanic, an unneeded extra step to do. Like, I would have been fine if in-game they said, like, maybe Abilene or Evie goes along the lines of, well, seeing as someone is going around killing people, I can't kill people myself because that would create more panic. They don't say that. They just leave it up in the air as to why she's doing it, which kind of hurts it more than helps it. As I said, the main missions are too short for any of the characters to get any sort of semblance of weight to them. Jack gets the most weight, but even then, it's not enough. Because the whole DLC is about him. But, like, the missions where you play as him are cool, and seeing into his mind is cool, with the whole way that the UI changes to show that he's unhinged. That's awesome. But the whole thing with, like, Nelly, like, who is Nelly? Why does Jacob care about her so much? Does he marry her? Is he some... Did they form sort of some sort of bond? It doesn't explain, and she's only there twice. At the beginning, and then during the mission when Evie tries to find her. And that's it. And it doesn't really do anything more with that. The only other times you see her is in the side missions, and it's kind of disappointing that's all she is a side character, side mission character at that point on. Then you've got Lady O, where it's like, oh, you've got to go kill Lady O because he's working with Jack the Ripper. Okay, why is she working with Jack the Ripper? What's her reasoning? Why is she willing to be like this tyrant over her prostitutes? It doesn't give enough weight. And then, like, oh, she's the only target. The only other person you got to kill is the warden. And the warden is just a guy that is looking over the prison cells for the Ripper. Okay, I guess. Number three, why is Jack the Ripper only now getting rid of evidence of his past? Why didn't he do that beforehand? He's talking about this nurse as though she was like beating him this whole time. It's like, well, why is that never mentioned before now? Why did you kill the doctor outside? Why is he doing any of this? It's not adequately explained beyond, oh, because his mother was killed by some stranger, so he's going to go out and kill women to show them? It's like, well, no, to shop the assassins. And it's like, the assassins aren't the police force. They don't go around killing random people. They go around killing Templars. The police deal with the other crimes. You should be blaming the police. And why go around killing women if your mother was killed? You'd think you'd be going around killing guys or men because they killed your mother or killed women. The fact that most of the upgrades that you get in the main game are void in this DLC, like, you can't have the ability to not allow people to escape anymore. You don't have, like, some of the combos or the bonuses to damage that you get. You just get what this DLC gives you, and you better be okay with it, because you're not be able to change it. You're only able to use your fists. You're not able to use this cane staff, which was a cool weapon, or a dagger. I like the fear tools, but I think they're underutilized, and the fact that we have, like, such a small upgrade tree for them is kind of disappointing. They tried to show a serial killer without trying to get too gruesome with it, and that's really the shame here. They're trying to do a character who mutilated women. It wasn't just a minor thing. It was like they had their guts splayed out everywhere, and they explain that, but they don't show it. And they're just thinking, like, oh, we'll just show some dead bodies and blood everywhere. That's enough. It's like, no, it's not. You've got to show the gruesomeness of this. Blood and bodies is not really going to do anything, because it doesn't really give how gruesome of a guy the Ripper was. They tried their best, but other games have done much better with it as a main source. I mean, look at the Sherlock Holmes series. They did Jack the Ripper justice in their games. I guess, overall, the feeling of this DLC is that it was a good attempt, and it has some good things in it. Like I said, I like the fear tools, and I like what they went with and the actual Jack the Ripper stuff. Because in my opinion, he's not really that utilized in games as much as I want him to. But the DLC is too short, doesn't go in far enough to give characters more depth, and just the variety is not there. It's kind of a disappointing DLC. I was actually really looking forward to playing it, but after playing it, I am disappointed. They could have done more with this. I ranted longer than that on that than I wanted, but it's the end of the series, so I thought I'd probably be best to put it here. So for now, that's the end of the Assassin's Creed Syndicate. There's no more. We're finally done with this, and we're done with Assassin's Creed for a bit. I do not have Origins, and I do not have Odyssey, so we will not be playing those until a later date when I'm actually able to get at least one of them. However, I will let it be known that I might not be looking forward to those because of how much they changed and made it not Assassin's Creed. But for now, this is the end of Syndicate. I hope you have enjoyed this series. I hope you all enjoyed the Jack the Ripper DLC, even if I was kind of disappointed with it. I hope everyone else was okay watching it. And yeah, until next time, guys, have a good week, have a good day. Thank you for watching this series, and I hope to see you all in any future ones I do of any other games. Until next time, guys, thanks for watching. Bye. Sleep well.